understanding of this world in its relation to the world to come. That is the only safe way of teaching people how they should mold their habits, how they should behave in this world to each other and of course to God. Then the Holy Quran points out to another very important attitude of such societies who have turned materialist. It says they declare, "In hiya illa hayatuna dunya, namutu wa nahya, wa ma nahnu bimabusin." Verily, this life here is end all. There is no more to it. We live and die here, and we shall certainly not be raised. Then again, they mockingly addressed earlier prophets by telling them, by asking them, "Aiza kunna idhaman wa rufatan ainna la mabuthuna fil khafi khalqin jadid." What do you mean? Do you make us believe that when we have died and turned into dust, we'll be raised again into a new form of creation? This, according to the Quran, is central to all the evils of a materialistic society. That is why so much stress is laid on the life to come and on a day of reckoning. So the Holy Quran declares, "Lillahi ma fis samawati wa ma fil ard wa in tudu ma fi anfusikum wa tufu yuhasibkum billah." Everything which you find in the heavens or in the earth belongs to God. He is the master. He has the right to shape your destinies and to shape your social behavior. In tubdu ma fi anfusikum wa tukhfuhu, whether you hide what is in your hearts or declare it, he would bring you to book and question you regarding your evil thoughts and evil doings. Then the Holy Quran declares, "Inna sama wal basara wal fuada kullu ulaika kana anhu masula." Verily, the faculty of hearing, the faculty of sight, and heart. And here, by heart, the Holy Quran means the ultimate life force which is behind every human mental operation. Fuad in the Holy Quran means that decisive, ultimate will in the man which operates brain like in the modern society you operate computers. So that Fuad, that final will also be answerable, will be held answerable. In Islamic concept of society, Islam moderates, disciplines, and trims natural desires which, if left uncontrolled, would play havoc with the gamut of human emotions. It discourages or prohibits the fulfillment of such desires as can result in more misery than pleasure for the society in the final analysis. At the same time, Islam cultivates new tastes and develops the ability to derive pleasure and satisfaction from such acts as may appear colorless, insipid, and tasteless to the uncultured. Tastes are modified and coarse sensual cravings are trained and refined and turned into aspirations for the sublime. The fundamentals of Islamic society, which have been mentioned in the Holy Quran, are as follows: "Inna Allaha yamru bil adli wal ihsani wa ita'i dhil qurba wa yanha anil fashai wal munkari wal baghi ya'idhukum la'allakum tadhakkarun." Verily, God enjoins justice and more than justice, to give people more than their dues, وَإِتَعِذِ الْقُرْبَى, and to serve humanity like they belong to you, like your kith and kin, like your near relatives. وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنْكَرِ وَالْبَغْيِ, and prohibits the display of evil, like you observe nowadays so often on television, radio, and streets of many societies of the world. وَالْمُنْكَرِ, and all that is considered wrong, not by religions, but by human conscience. It is common to everyone, which man, if he searches deep into his own self, he delves deeper into his own conscience, he would declare it to be wrong. So all such behavior is to be shunned and condemned. Wal-baghi, and everything which leads to rebellions and chaos. يَيَذُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ, God admonish you, may you benefit from this admonishment. In Islamic concept of society, there are no generation gaps which are causing so much discomfort and pain to the modern societies in the world. The Holy Quran, speaking of the rights of the parents and the rights of the children upon the parents, declares, among many verses, I would only recite one which mentions both. Have I misplaced it, unfortunately? Yes, here it is. وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَشْهُدُونَ الزُّورَ وَإِذَا مَرُّوا بِاللَّغْوِ مَرُّوا كِرَامًا وَالَّذِينَ إِذَا ذُكِّرُوا بِآيَاتِ رَبِّهِمْ لَمْ يَخِرُّوا عَلَيْهَا صُمًّا وَبُكْمًا وَالَّذِينَ يَقُولُونَ رَبَّنَا هَبْ لَنَا مِنْ أَزْوَاجِنَا وَذُرِّيَّاتِنَا قُرَّةَ أَعْيُنٍ وَاجْعَلْنَا لِلْمُتَّقِينَ إِمَامًا. Those who bear not false witness, and when they pass by anything vain, they pass by with dignity. And those who, when they are reminded of the signs of their Lord, fall not down thereat deaf and blind. And those who say, Our Lord, grant us of our wives and children the delight of our eyes, and make us a model for the righteous. Then the Holy Quran says, وَعْبُدُ اللَّهَ وَلَا تُشْرِكُوا بِهِ شَيْئًا وَبِالْوَالِدَيْنِ إِحْسَانًا وَبِذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْيَتَامَى وَالْمَسَاكِينِ وَالْجَارِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَالْجَارِ الْجُنُبِ وَالصَّاحِبِ بِالْجَنْبِ وَابْنِ السَّبِيلِ وَمَا مَلَكَتْ أَيْمَانُكُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ مَنْ كَانَ مُخْتَالًا فَخُورًا. The society can be best cemented by furthering the relationship not only in one single direction of seeking base sensual pleasures, but by diversifying your directions and channels of seeking pleasure in the form of satisfaction. So the Holy Quran declares, first of all, you must be mindful of kindness to your parents. And in other words, the Holy Quran says, the believers pray to God, make us as kind to our parents as they have been to us when they brought us up. So if the modern society learns its lesson from these injunctions, many problems which you face today and which